Hey everyone, and welcome back to another episode of the Stretford End. I trust you guys are doing well, and we are leading up to another game against Wolves on Sunday. And to start off this week, I first have to definitely say that it's not been a good week, and there are various factors for that. But we'll first most definitely go into speaking about the game against Southampton. So it was a 1-1 draw. A bit lackluster from the boys, and it didn't really look like we wanted to win the game. I think we lost the game already in the starting 11 with Ole making changes that was not needed to be made. No understanding as to why he did not start Sancho on the right. He moved Greenwood from centre forward last weekend against Leeds to against Southampton to play on the right wing when we have a right winger sitting on the bench. No disrespect to Victor Lindelof, but perhaps Varane should have started. He should have gotten a good run out. I don't think there's an excuse that could have been made for him not to play. You can't say that he needs match fitness. I mean, how else is he supposed to get match fitness without playing? So it would have made sense for him to come and play against alongside Maguire. I think we probably would have defended better, especially for the goal that Southampton scored. Yes, some might say that Bruno Fernandes was fouled, but in my opinion, no foul. Basically, he saw the guy coming. He saw Jack Stevens coming to his back, and he allowed Jack Stevens to win the ball. And the ref saw that. He saw the little sneak peek with his look to see if, you know, there was a defender coming. And that's what kind of gave the game away. And that is why the ref did not deem it a foul. And that is why, you know, we should have reacted after that. You know, we should have closed down the shot. Fred found himself next to Maguire in defending the shot rather than going towards the man to close him down with more efficiency, which was kind of not very smart. In the game alone, Fred looked very lost. His passes were abysmal. He seemed to not know where he is half of the time on the pitch. He was not aware of the players around him. Running in and diving into tackles with players just touching it, passing. There was the 18-year-old from Southampton that was playing right back, completely skinned him time and time again. And that is concerning. If he wants to be a part of our team, he needs to improve. And again, ultimately, I don't think he belongs in the team. I don't think he is the standard that we need in the team, especially in midfield. And partnering him alongside Matic was just one of the worst ideas Ole could have come up with. It is too slow. It is too static. Both of them cannot play the ball out from the back. Yes, Matic could do it in his younger years, but he's not there anymore. He's too slow on the turn. He slows us down on a counter-attack. And again, it brings me to the question why these players started the game. Why they were put into this game when we had a winning team from last weekend against Leeds. We didn't need to make any changes. You should have played the exact same team. Yes, maybe as I said before, bringing in Sancho and Varane to just, you know, boost the team, you know, that already won last week against Leeds. But he didn't do that. He thought that he needed to start certain players to give them a bit of a go start. Players like Anthony Martial, who basically was out for 5 months, didn't have a preseason at all. And he basically, you know, didn't do anything. He barely touched the ball, doesn't make runs in behind. He doesn't look to get on the end of things. He doesn't look to support the team in build-up play. When he has an opportunity to hold up the ball, he loses it. So it seems a lot like Anthony Martial doesn't seem interested in playing for United. And he doesn't seem to care that his place has been taken by Cavani and that Greenwood might be overtaking him as the number nine in the future. He seems to just be quite fine with being a bit part player and just being on the field, you know, which is kind of very upsetting. It's very annoying that he doesn't work for the team. There was a moment where Bruno had to run right past him to go and press the ball, and he was just walking and not even giving any impetus to try and go and close down the ball. And that showed a lot, you know, it showed a lot in terms of his attitude and his mentality. Donny van de Beek, I feel that he should have started as well. Perhaps if he played alongside Matic, we would have seen a different game. Because he would have moved the ball quicker. He's press resistant. He's able to handle the ball when under pressure. You know, he would have quickly moved the ball forward for us. He's a technically gifted footballer. And he would have helped Fred, you know, in those moments when having to pass the ball forward and, you know, break those defensive lines that Southampton had. But we're not sure what's happening with Donny. We don't understand how this is actually making sense. But nevertheless, we will have to see what happens against Wolves, and we hope and pray that Donny does start. We hope that Sancho starts and Varane starts, and that we definitely need to go and win. It's without a doubt that we need to win against Wolves. We need to get the 3 points. We need to ensure that we are clinical up front and not waste chances. The set pieces chances we had against Southampton, we need to take them, especially against Wolves. We need to capitalize on those because we have quite a few tall players, such as Maguire, and hopefully if Varane starts, he'll be another threat in the opposition box. But I do hope that we win against Wolves, and the team that I want to play will be David De Gea in goal. I want Maguire and Varane to start, Shaw at left back, Wan-Bissaka at right back. In midfield, I want Donny to start alongside Fred. Now, the reason why I say Fred, I understand Fred didn't have a good game against Southampton, but he's much more mobile and quicker than Matic would be. So perhaps Donny and Fred in midfield, and then Bruno playing in the number 10 role. And of course, I'm sure that Ole would want to go and start Pogba on the left. So that might be what he would go for. So he would probably start Pogba on the left. On the right-hand side, I want Sancho to start without a doubt. And up front, he needs to start Greenwood, who is in absolute imperious form at the moment. So that is the team I want to start, and that I definitely believe will be the team that will go on and win the game for us. Yes, Wolves is a very good team. They have started the season decently enough. New management, new tactics. But I'm sure we can go and we can win the game on Sunday. Moving along to the Champions League draw that had taken place yesterday. And it seems that we have a very good group that has been tainted for us, where we are in the group with Villarreal, Atalanta, and BSC Young Boys. Now, of course, we know Villarreal from the Europa League final that won us on penalties. And this is an opportunity for us to stake a revenge plot. An opportunity for us to completely put them into their coffin and ensure that they do not qualify. Let us and Atalanta be the ones to qualify and allow them to go back to the Europa League where they belong. They finished seventh in their respective La Liga season last season, so it only makes sense that they stay in the Europa League, in my opinion. But it is a very good group, a group that is, I wouldn't say easy, but I would say decent enough for us to win it and also get into the knockout rounds and get a favorable draw in the round of 16. So not much to speak about in the Champions League, but when the fixtures do come out, we'll definitely get speaking on that and also previewing those matches. Now, I want to go into something that is really dear to my heart and that has hurt me and that has actually made this week very difficult. And it is to do with transfer news, but it is not to do with United transfer news. There hasn't been much going on within United's transfer setup with regards to incomings. But outgoings, Brandon Williams is on loan to Norwich City. Axel Tuanzebe has gone to Aston Villa on loan. Tahith Chong is doing his best bits at Birmingham City. You look at players at Dylan Levert, who went to Scotland to go and play on loan there. James Garner went back to Nottingham Forest for another loan after signing a long-term contract with us. So the players that we expect to go out on loan have gone out on loan. Andres Pereira went to Flamengo in Brazil on loan with the thought of wanting to be in the Brazil national squad for the World Cup next year. All the best to him. And I'm sure that he can definitely make an impact to do so if he decides to work hard. That is just basically a bit part news about the outgoings of United. But the one I want to speak about is the rumors and the stories that have been coming out of Cristiano Ronaldo going to Manchester City, which I feel is the biggest betrayal to date. And for me personally, not just as a United fan, but also as a fan of Ronaldo, a supporter of him as a footballer and as a human being, for that matter. I followed him ever since, you know, I heard him as a player when he was scouted by United, you know, and brought to United. I followed stories of his background, of his history, you know, of his father, his mother, you know, his friends, his family, looking along the lines, how he performed for United and improved as a player, improved as a man, you know, the amount of respect he had for Sir Alex Ferguson, who he claimed time and time again was his footballing father, who he couldn't thank enough for, you know, making him the person that he is and for being there for him. When he left for Real Madrid, you know, he was the best player in the world at the time, and that was understandable. Real Madrid was a dream of his, and he always wanted to play for them as a kid, and that's something you cannot take away from him. And he went there and he created history of his own, and he is a Real Madrid legend, he's a Man United legend. But, you know, after going to Juventus and not really doing what he wanted to do there, and that is bring a Champions League for them, basically, now he wants to leave the club. He's told them not to play him. He's saying goodbye to his teammates. It's of the latest news that I've heard about. And his agent, George Mendes, has gone to speak to Manchester City and gone to agree his contract already. And From what the reports have been said, it's already agreed. His personal terms are already agreed. And that is difficult to take because, again, myself as a player, when I was playing football, I patented myself to his ability. I perfected, his free kick technique. I tried to, train the way he did so that I can improve my own performances. I looked up to him. I still do to this day. I respected him. This is very difficult, guys, to speak about. And, it's something that I didn't think would happen. And I still believe that it won't happen. It's just rumors in the papers, but it's looking more and more concrete. He himself said that money was never a drive for him for football. But look now, he doesn't have any other options. PSG doesn't want him. Our board, for some reason, doesn't want to go and get him, which is very weird because this is an absolute tap in terms of media, marketing, PR, selling t-shirts, looking at, bringing more fans to the club. The amount of love that he would receive, he could create another movie like, A Last Dance, on Netflix, similar to that. But with him even just considering going to City, that's difficult to take. It's a difficult pill to swallow. For someone who we thought had respect for United, we thought had respect for Sir Alex, let alone the fans. Understand this. Us as fans, our opinions mean nothing to these players. Yes, some players might show that they, love their fans, etc., etc., but in the ultimate thing, there is no voice for fans with regards to loyalty. As loyal as we are to the clubs we support, players are not as loyal as that. Some of them might are, like the Scholes, the Giggs, those type of players, the Francesco Tottis from Italy, etc., they were loyal players of their club. Now, we don't know. I don't know. It's even difficult for me to speak about it. I can't fathom the thought of him wearing a t-shirt of City. I can't fathom him playing for the, I can't fathom him playing against us. I just can't. And I hope that he might come to his senses. I hope that, it's just, I don't know. Let's hope something happens in the future and that it doesn't happen. If it does, it wouldn't surprise me. It's, like I said, a tap in for any club who can afford him. But right now, City is the only club that wants him, according to reports. And it's a difficult pill to swallow. But as I've said before, it is the biggest and ultimate betrayal. I don't think I will be able to forgive him. I know it sounds petty and childish, but from a footballing sense, I don't think I'll be able to forgive him. And don't tell me about Peter Schmeichel went to go play for City and Paul Ince went to go play for Liverpool and Dennis Irwin who moved over. And no, don't tell. I don't want. There's different times, different people, different players, and money was never there, was never a thing back then. This is difficult, and I just hope it doesn't materialize. If it does, it doesn't surprise me, and we'll just have to swallow the pill, but it will be very, very difficult. And it will be very, very heartbreaking as well. But thank you guys for joining me. I trust that you guys enjoyed the video. Please definitely subscribe, leave a like, and also comment below on what your opinions are on what you've spoken about in the video today. And let's go and get the 3 points on Sunday against Wolves. That is it from me, Sachin Johnson, and the Stratford End. Goodbye.